last interview for today. Thank you very much for having me. You're responsible for HR here, right?
Yes, I am. We call it people, actually. We don't call it HR.
Oh, you don't call it HR?
No.
Okay, very interesting. From your perspective, what do you say about, you know, the development of the startup ecosystem in Lagos regarding developers and all the people that you actually need and all the people who, are looking for jobs? And, you know, what is the current status of the startup ecosystem in Lagos?
Okay, so it's interesting, and I want to take it not just from Lagos, but from Nigeria as a whole. It's a huge opportunity. If you ask me, I see in the next 10 years, the startup sector being a huge contributor to the to Nigeria's economy. Mm-hmm. And it's interesting because those startups are not, they're not really, maybe a bit of logistics, maybe agriculture, but then everything is looking at how technology can fit into their businesses. Mm-hmm. So you'd realize that there's a huge, like, likelihood of boom in the fintech space, in the technology space, basically, because everyone is looking at how to automate. And so when I look at Nigeria, and I mean Lagos being the hub, I see startups springing up, which brings about opportunity for people to learn and to grow, which brings about the opportunity for people to learn about technology as well. And then you have a lot of people in Nigeria. I mean, our population is huge.
Yes.
We have a huge percentage are young people, millennials and below. Mm. And so you realize that what the ecosystem needs is to give these people the opportunity to learn about what software development is all about.
Yeah.
So right now, not everyone can afford the expensive software developers with 10, 15 years of experience. Mm. But then you have lots of like young, intelligent people who don't mind applying themselves and learning about this skill, about this language, programming languages.
Yeah.
And so, yes, you in the same space, you see a huge gap, but then you also see a huge opportunity.
Absolutely.
So for companies like Softcom, we're realizing that what we need to do is to be able to find the maybe the most intelligent ones and the ones who are interested in software development, and then also give them the opportunity to expose them to building products, and you also give them time to grow as well, because I mean you can't build an experienced developer in a day.
Yeah.
And so those are some of the things that, I mean, some of the experiences that, you know, we're having.
I mean, what was very, very interesting also for me to learn, just before our interview here, you told me Germany is taking away all the developers in Lagos. You know, that's for me like a crazy thing to hear, because like I wasn't aware of that. But
So I've worked in, this is the third tech company I'm working in, and the previous two, we actually tease and say there's like an alumni of the organizations in Germany, because which is one of the challenges that we actually have in Nigeria, because you have someone who maybe you have exposed to software development as an engineer and so forth and so on, and then you're seeing lots of prospects with this person. The person's learning fast, and in 2-3 years, the person just comes and like, oh, I'm moving to Germany. And you can't compete salary-wise, you can't compete because, I mean, the person is getting a better standard of living. So Germany, please!
I'm very sorry to take away all your good developers, but I bet there are more good developers coming up here.
Well, yes, there are. That's the interesting thing. Yes, there are. And I think another challenge that we are having is the fact that yes, we have lots of young people who are interested, but then we don't have enough mentors.
Yeah.
We don't have enough people who are willing to invest in them, invest the time, invest the resources in them to say, look, I want to bring you up to becoming this excellent developer.
Yeah.
So that's also lacking as well.
Yeah.
Because you realize that once a developer gets to that point, he's moving on. But we have, I mean, the ecosystem, because of our population, we have that as a huge advantage.
Yeah.
So we have loads of young people who are eager to learn and they want to know, look, if I have this opportunity, I'm willing to take it and make the best out of it.
I mean, I'm learning a lot to see how companies are coping with, you know, different kind of problems that they're facing. Thank you very much for these insights. It's been great.
Thank you. Thank you for the interview. Thank you for the time.
No, absolutely. You don't have to. And I will move on now.
Okay.
Right, thank you very much. Hug again. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
She asked me if I hug. So what kind of question? Yes, of course I do. Thank you very much.